Sports injuries, for instance to the cruciate ligament, can lead to knee instability that can cause pain and reduced function. Also, osteoarthritis is an increasing problem due to the increased elderly population and for which joint replacement is the final resort. However, although successful, 20% of patients are not satisfied and joint instability after the surgery is a frequently occurring problem. My name is Michael Skipper Anderson. I'm an associate professor at the Department of Materials and Production of Aalborg University. So currently in the clinics, there are three ways to measure knee joint laxity. One is manual test, where the doctor is manually subjecting the knee to a load, but this is subjective and also inaccurate. Then there are clinical arthrometers, which use a device to apply the load, but rely on the movement of the skin and are therefore also inaccurate. And then there are stress x-rays, which although they provide an accurate measurement, only do this in two dimensions. So therefore we have introduced a new 3D knee joint laxity technology where we can accurately assess how loose the knee is and we can do it in three dimensions. To do this, we have a technology that consists of a chair that the patient is situated on and we fix the thigh to the chair. Then the lower leg is inserted in a boot that is attached to a robotic platform that can move in three dimensions. And at the same time, we measure the forces that we apply to the lower leg. We do this in a safe manner and apply only the loads in the same magnitude as the surgeon would do when he do manual assessments of you, but it enables that we can do it in three dimensions and we can assess all the loads that we want. Due to this setup, we can also combine the technology with measurements or models of the knee, computer models to predict the outcome of surgical interventions. And in this way, we expect that we can improve the surgical procedures both for ligament injuries and for joint replacement. And in this way, give people a better outcome and remain active after surgery so they can go skiing, running, and play golf. If you want to hear more, please contact us.